Dear students, today I am going to discuss on objectives of operating systems. Objective means something like we say it as your goal for which you are carrying out certain activities. So the objective of the operating systems, the very first point we consider is convenience. Now, what exactly the convenience means is that while we are operating, say, a computer or a mobile, in such situations, the user must find it very convenient to use it. And if, say for example, a person is a layman and he does not know how to read and write, and if he want to use the mobile, that should be a more convenient way the person can able to handle it, he or she can handle it. So an operating system should be in such a way that user can use it in a friendly way. Friendly manner, I can put it as friendly manners. So, between the users, if this is a users and this is your hardware, between this one, the operating system should be such that if a user want to give a print command, the hardware should do. If a user want to watch the video, it can able to. If a user want to draw something in the a computer or in the mobile, the operating system should support. Instead of having a different functional activity, the operating system itself will carry out all the functional activities of the users. Means, suppose this is one activity, so let us take that paintbrush. This is, say, .doc. Here is doing PowerPoint. Another time, user want to do a MP3 files. All these things, whatever the user want to do, it gives to the operating system, and operating system accordingly allows the hardware when and how to carry out. So that is how the things we say. It is in a convenience way. Now, if working with, let us take MS-DOS, MS Word, or MS Excel, or any other activities, the system should perform in such a way that the user no need to bother how the data of or how the user's requirement is being fulfilled by the hardware. What are the hardware it does is that hardware will display the things. Hardware means if I say hard disk, it will store it. If it is a hardware in the memory, it will do a folder in which the file will be there. All this thing is carried by the operating system in a most convenient manner. That is why it is termed as a convenience. That means rather just to save it, it itself carry out many activities as per the user's needs. Next work is that area of the operating system's objective is nothing but it increase work efficiency. Efficiency is such word is nothing but how whenever a user do any applications, if that is efficient and if it is able to process in a very speedy manners by the particular computer or any systems, then we say that the system is more efficient. So there is a word efficiency, see, and utilizations. When we say that computer is efficiently process the things, means that any inputs whatever you give, the computer is capable, CPU is capable of processing output. That means if your CPU system is say i5, And on the other hand, your old, if your CPU is very old, like a 286 or a 386 systems, that what the i5 can able to process, that same thing 286 cannot able to process. Then we say that i5 is more efficient than 286. That means it can able to produce the output for a given input. Utilizations means if you are having a CPU, let us take a CPU, and you are giving a different works, say task 1, task 2, task 3. After one first task, immediately the second task should start, immediately the third. Then we say that the CPU is properly utilized. So that is why. So here, since we are talking efficiency, we say that the objective of the operating system is to see that the CPU should be able to process the things efficiently. So that is the things. Another third point, which is that with the help of CPU, is that it should have an ability to create new functions. New functions means what? Suppose if you are working on with OS, and if a new process is to create, then OS will support a new functions and process. That means, say for example, this is the operating systems. I put it as an example. If a person is capable of not able to write the cycles, but he can able to hold the cycle and he can able to keep moving along with the cycles. That means the cycle, if cycle is a OS, the user's requirement, if it is not able to meet by riding, at least it can, the user can able to ride, instead of riding, it can able to move along with the cycles by sliding in a way, the way users try to do it by sliding a certain things on the surface. So this is in the same way, operating systems can carry out a very different various functions. So if there is a functions let us take an example that you want to run a MP4, and if MP4 file is in a different format, and if you are seeing this MP4 in a different format, say that you are seeing in a VLC media files, and in place of VLC media files, say for example you want to process it in a KM player, these are nothing but a video files. So users MP3 files can be displayed in the VLC and it can be displayed in a KM file. So different functional activity the operating systems can be able to do. Similarly, working on a word processor or a Excel at the same time, and you want to enjoy the MP4, that is also supported by the operating system. That means more than, suppose this is function 1, function 2, here MP3. You want to see MP3 along with the processing video, that is also possible. So everything, every functional activities can be carried out with the operating systems. So this is the three very basic importance with respect to the objective of the operating systems. Thank you.